Primarily, a group of swaras, definite swaras, which is taken, and with the rules and regulation, which swara is to be taken and not to be taken, which is the important swar in that, which is called vadi, samvadi, anuvadi. Now, for example, we can take Raag Bihag. I have taken because it has just as he, your name please?
Paramvik.
As he explained that there is a pakar, that means a specific group which has to be taken like that only. So in Bihag, you see the re is very small. Ga re sa sa ga ma pa ga ma ga re sa ga re sa, just like that corresponding ni da pa ma pa ga ma ga re sa. So whenever this pakad will come, you will recognize that this is Raag Bihag. But this is not just Raag. So in Alap, what will happen? And you see, when we are rendering the Raag, it is not a sargam, it is akar, just ala, a. Now, gandhar is the main swara. That means we will stop often on that note, which is called vadi. This is the format of improvisation of the Raag within the roots and within the regulations. Now we can have a little bit of tabla. Just as we have Saregama Padhani Sa as swaras, we have the bowls Dha, Din, Din Dha, Tin, Trako. And with these bowls, just as out of swaras we compose the Raag. Just like that, out of all these various bowls, specific bowls are taken together to form a taal, a time cycle. Again, as there are raags with 5 swaras, 7 swaras, 6 swaras, there are taals with 8 matras, 16 matras, 6 matras, 7 matras, and they have different bowls. So the most common taal is the teen taal or tri taal of 16 beats. Dha din dinda, dha din dinda, dha tin tinta, ta din dinda. There is always the calculation of the half of the taal also, and it is called kaan. So, zara sir, khali tinta, dha din dinda, slow matra. Dha, din, ek matra sir, over. Tin, tin, ta. One cycle is over. The next dha which will come will be the sam, the first matra. So that has to be followed by the singer. The note, the word of the composition which is originally coming on dha has to come on dha only. Every time when one alap is finished or one taan is finished. Just as that, we will have just one of the examples of other. The simplest is dadra. 6 matras. Dha dhina, dha tina. Of the Raag is woven along with the taal. So Mr. Shubha Mittal will now render one composition Raag after taal along with the taal, so that you can have an idea. Now we will have the group composition also only. You see, there are two compositions in classical music. The bilambic composition, which the lay is very slow. Then Gil. There is a syllabic in which the alapi is there. That's a major portion of improvisation is there in the kya. But for the having the idea of the coordination of the composition and the taal, we'll have the drut bandish, which is in the past life.
Missing a small piece in Kedar, name of the rag is Kedar.
Rag Kedar.
Taal is old.
Teen taal only piece.
Thank you.
शुरुआत
ऐसे
शुरू We must have realized. First, it was an alap in slow, but last two cycles, it was a taan, which is in a fast rhythm and which requires lots of practice. Alap needs lots of contemplation, and taan needs lots of practice. Now we can just move on to the time theory as such. Just as I told you, the time theory is based on the presumption. That the notes in our music or any music, a group of notes has a typical atmosphere or effect on the listener and the singer. Just as there are, if the Komal Swaras are there, Komal Re, it has a little bit of different type of effect on you. If the Gandhar, Madhyam, Panchama, Shuddha we are taking, it has a little bit of pleasant type of atmosphere. And based on this, the rags. Time, the specific time at which the rag is sung has been decided by our ancestors. It is this theory has been coming down to us from the oldest of tradition. That means even in Drupada, whenever that means at when the rags were formed, the time theory was formed with them only. Now we can have major four periods of the day. First, you see, as there are rags of particular season. They have divided the rags during the daytime also. They have thought of so much that what is our mood in the morning? What is our mood in the afternoon? What is the nature in the afternoon? What is the situation in the nature in the evening and night? So corresponding to our moods and the moods of nature, the rags have been decided accordingly. Now, in the early morning, we are always having the contemplation, a little bit of meditative mood and a little bit of slow as such. And as such, in the morning and in the twilight, there are specific ragas with Komal Re, Komal Gandhar, Komal Daivat as such. So we can have one morning rag as such.
And as you would say that you like without telling them.
Okay,
this
now
is a morning rag.
I'll sing one rag and you can tell me what type of atmosphere you feel like that. It's not a morning rag. Take alap because that will only create. Some mood or something you feel. I will just explain a little bit of you so you can appreciate a little bit. In the morning, the sun is rising. So you see, in the morning or at the twilight ragas, they are more in the lower octave. And they have this Re Komal, which gives a little bit of philosophical thing. Hum jo kehte hain ki vairagya jo kuch hota hai. So this group of Komal Ray, Gandhar Shuddha, this is taken as twilight rags, and these are at early morning or in the evening, where the ray is invariably Komal. Just as you, if you take the corresponding rag in the evening, Marwa, it has Komal Rishabh, but Gandhar is Shuddha and Daivat is also Shuddha. So that is also twilight rag, but that is in the evening. So they have divided it in the morning and evening ragas. The same group, but a little bit of difference. Marwa, okay. विभाग में बैठ गया वो थोड़ी बैठ गया
थोड़ी ऐसे बस
Twilight. Then in the afternoon there are different rags, in the night there are different rags. One of we can have just one night rag, so can we can go ahead. One of the popular rags is Malkaus. You must be knowing Malkaus. So that is a late night rag. Where Pancham is Varja, Madhyam is there, Gandhar is Komal. And it has a little bit of, jaise hum Hindi mein Gambhir kehte hain, a little bit of dignified swaroop hai uska. तबुन दे improvisation in art. Gandhar, Madhyam, Pancham, and the sur which I have taken now is the upper sa. This completes the picture of the raga. This is the what we can say just contracted form of a khyal. Now we can have the thumri, you see, because
aur kuch nahi tarana le lijiye, ek tarana le lijiye, ek dupahar ki raag le lijiye, jaise
acha sare
le lijiye, jaise subah, jaise shaam, raat, ha morning, raat, ya tarana 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 le lijiye,
kahan
tarana kar lijiye
aap,
ha tarana.
One more type of pattern is the tarana. where the words don't have any meaning. It's just to show the skill of the singer.
Syllables, and different syllables.
Yes. There are but syllables that means tananano, yalaliyo, just like that. And generally the tarana is sung in fast lay and it goes on increasing. I'm not very much used to sing tarana, just I'll give it. This is the tarana in rag Yaman. Yaman is the basic rag of Indian classical music. The training of any student starts with Yaman, which is a sampurna rag. Dani rim tanana derena, dani rim tanana derena, dani rim tanana derena, da da re dani dena dena rim tarim, rim tanana derena, dani rim tanana derena, dani rim tanana derena derena, dani rim tanana derena. Dani dim tanana derena, tadare dani dena dena dim tarim, dim tanana derena, dani dim tanana derena, tanom 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 tanom, yalali yalali om tadare tadare dum, dhatir kit dum tir kit tir kit ta dani 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 dim. Tanana derena, dani rim tanana derena, dani rim tanana derena, dani rim. Dim tanana nana, dim tanana nana, tarim dim tanana, tarim dim tanana, 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 dim tanana derena, dani rim. This is just to a 5 minutes or 2 minutes piece, which has to be sung in very fast lay. Now we can have a chundi, I think. Just as we had the examples of morning rag and evening and night, we'll have a little bit of afternoon rag, one of the example of afternoon rags. Sarang is the main rag in the afternoon, and there are very many types of sarangs, but the main rag which is sung in the afternoon, 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, is the sarang prakar. Yeah.
ask you now, you know, the ragas that you heard the morning and the night and the evening and afternoon, I mean, what impact have they had on you? Could you sort of imagine the atmosphere or anything? I just want to know for my own curiosity.
The twilight rags have a little bit of, and the thing is that, you see, the rag has to be at least 15 minutes or 20 minutes so that it has effect. Just a group of notes, but they have the atmosphere as such. But especially the twilight rags have the distinction, at least I think so. Not but the in between.
You ask others also who are new to Tibet.
No, we are having the first group like that. That's completely alien to music. That's why it struck my mind just while I was talking to you. It struck my mind. It's the first experiment.
I think you still have to grow on people. The more you
We have the clean slate today, yes. So that means that what.
No, actually, with some rags, we have very strong character. Whereas others don't have an immediate impact. A rag, for example, which is called Shri, has they're not harmonious. I mean, they're in dissonance with each other, and yet they create an atmosphere of restlessness or of tragedy, which is so apparent that that even a child would react to it. And other rags don't have such a strong kind of, it's like any other person, it's like a group of people. Some people, for whatever reason, stand out and others grow on you. So the rags are also like that. Shri is depending on the composition. That's another subtlety. Depending on the composition, each composition, one rag may present more than one ras or mood, depending on the composition. Certain, she sang Malkos, and it was a devotional piece. And yet, most classic examples of Malkos are often called Veer Ras Pradhan. So they have an aggressive quality also. It also depends on the composition, and naturally once the composition has a certain mood, the interpretation also changes.
And a lot depends, the interpretation. You see, that's why you see individual improvisation within the limits of the raga. Artistry of the musician lies there. If he wants to portray the a composition which is of a sad mood, and so he renders that.
Yeah, this rag, now in Shri itself,
in Shri.
The notes, if you sing them like this, would definitely convey a sadness. And yet, there are certain compositions. Karan de re kachu lala re, karan de. It's about a child. Karan de kachu lala re. कुछ लला कुछ करने दो, शोर मचा रहे, तंग कर रहे, तो करन दे रे कछु लला रे, करन दे रे कछु लला रे, करन दे. Now the entire mood changes because of the composition.
अच्छा एक सुहासिनी जी, एक मल्हार के थोड़ा सा, क्योंकि आजकल एक तो बरसात का मौसम है, एंड दैट मल्हार कैन बी सांग एट एनी टाइम ऑफ द डे बिकॉज इट्स एंटायरली फॉर द सीजन. सो
जस्ट एज द रागस आर डिवाइडेड इन द टाइम ऑफ डे, देयर आर स्पेसिफिक रागस फॉर स्पेसिफिक सीजंस आल्सो, जस्ट लाइक बसंत इज सांग इन स्प्रिंग. नाउ व्हाइल सिंगिंग मल्हार द सिंगर ट्राइज टू ब्रिंग द एटमोसफियर दैट इज द ब्लैक क्लाउड्स, the thunder storm, the lightning, so that there is the meen and alap also and very forceful taans also to show the thunder and the lightning also. So again it depends upon how the raag is exposed. Taken together, ni ni sa re pa ga 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 ma re ni ni sa a. एक ताल तेरी पियो पियो बोले पपिया पियो पियो बोले पपे पियो पियो बोले पपिया पियो पियो बोले पपिया पियो पियो बोले पियो पियो बोले पपिया पियो पियो बोले पियो पियो बोले पपिया पियो पियो बोले पपिया पियो पियो बोले पपिया रानी many types of malla, but Mia malla is the main rag from which the various types of malla have been evolved.
एक चीज आपसे ऐसे कर सकते हैं, जरा थोड़ा समझा दीजिएगा कि हालात क्या होती है, तान बोल तान.
हाँ, yes, yes, yes. Now, alap, I think you have understood, because the first thing in akar or with the slow motion which we do, I just explain one after another for one.
Also, Khyal being an improvisatory genre.
No, they want just an example as it. Alap ye hai, taan ye hai.
Because it's of its improvisatory nature, the singer tries as far as possible, or the singer or the instrumentalist tries his best to follow certain patterns even in the improvisation, because all these forms are basically they're incorporating two things. There's the liberty of improvisation, and yet there's a certain law. So there are these two paradoxes working at the same time. I mean, you have certain rules, and yet at the same time, you're supposed to improvise, and there's supposed to be a spontaneity, and that is where the virtuosity of each artist comes in. Mm-hmm. And so to improvise, there are certain patterns which we usually follow, and then they are added to by people who have exceptional genius and who have a certain. They have their own particular style, they evolve a particular style. So basically alap, taan or gamak or meer, all these are patterns which are followed by artists to improvise, since it's a totally improvisatory genre.
We can have one after another, just a small, just specific information. We'll take rag yaman only, the basic rag. This is alap. Then that is the main note. That means the slow motion, it can be akar or the words can be given. Sharana jare, sharana jare. This is alap. Yes, you have something to ask me. Yes, this is the slow motion, slow improvisation in a slow rhythm and slow motion. These are prolonged. Yes, always comes in. It is built up and then afterwards the rhythm. But
and the structure
always
of the raga, you see, is established.
Yes, there can be words. Yes.
But there's a difference.
It means bol alap. We say it bol alap. But generally, when we are rendering the composition, to improve the effect, the singer just doesn't take just a, he weaves the bowls also in that. So it is bowl alap. Technically speaking, that is bowl alap. But then it is also alap only. Basically, it is alap.
But the alap, the dhrup that you heard for Dhrupad,
that is different.
That is different, you see. That is where it's called, you know, nom tom. They use it in nom tom and without
tananana.
And very slow, then madhlay, then drut, it goes on like that. The whole thing, the part of Dhrupad Gayaki is alap, which is not used in khayal gayaki. Khayal, it is the ochar that is in alap. You show the structure of the raga and the development, and then you start it. You can elaborate the slow elaboration with the words also. You call that.
And this alap is taken, that means the raga is developed through alap step by step. The singer will not just go to the upper sa. He will first establish the lower octave. He will improvise how many times he can do with variations, and step by step with each note he will go up, and then he will reach the upper sa, and then after that the rag, the swarup is complete, then he will move to the gamak or tan or bol tan, what is there.
This improvisation is
yes.
You decide before.
No. You say it happens during the.
So if you want to sing the same thing half an hour later.
Yes, it becomes different. It becomes. That's the beauty of the khyal singing, and that's why it became so popular after Dhrupad, because it gives a variety to the singer as well as the listener. The same composition, I'll sing something else. That means the serial will not be the same. That I will take Nire Gama or I may take Nimagare, whatever it is, whatever will come to my mind at that time. So this is alap. Then in alap, after alap there is boltan. That means after the alap is complete, up to the upper sa, we increase the rhythm. And then we weave the bolts of the composition in the swar and the lay and the tal. Now we can have the bol tan as such. Now first I was singing Guru Sharana Ja, Sharana Ja. Theka dijiye thoda sa. Vilambit ek tal jo hai, ek hi avartan lenge aap, kyunki aap interested hain isliye. Guru Sharana Ja Re. Third. Mana Me Re. Sab maan abhi maan Guru Sharan Ja. One cycle has ended here after 12 beats. This was whole one cycle. Now one alap in this lay only. After the reaching sa, we will have this rhythm, double the rhythm. Now we will weave the words in that. Guru Sharana Ja, Sharana Ja, Sharana Ja, Re Guru Sharana.
शरण जा गुरु शरण जा माना मेरे छाड़ दे सब मान अभिमान गुरु शरण जा दिस इज बोलता No, this is the second one. First main is the alap. That was the beginning.
Yeah.
Afterward, this is the second part. Now there will be gamak tan, that means. In this like also we can have. This is gamak yukta tan. Gamak is, Dagar brothers must have also explained. The breathing also comes in the. This is very difficult. It sounds very simple. Guru Sharan Ja. Now the simple tan. You will feel the lightness. This is gamak. This is tan. Guru Sharan Ja 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 Guru Sharan I may do whatever it is, but on the sum I have to come. Sharanaja. That also I have to see to it. That I may do anything in between, but I have to come on the first matra of the sum. What that means? No, you see, if you know the swaras, then you will have. Tan, acha, ha. Ha, yes. You see, there are 3-4 types. One is sapat tan. Now you must know, it is not the same. This is a different type. This is going by step. This is coming down. That means we are mixing the thing. You see, presentation is not riyaz. So we can, if we just take